Due to issues with both audio and video quality of original source material, lower quality material has been substituted where needed.
Beautifully crafted American clocks on display here at the California Academy of Sciences, and a different kind of craftsmanship went into the making of the subject of our next story. We're talking here about California clunkers. Now, clunkers are basically Schwinn bikes, rugged framed bikes with big balloon tires, and onto these bikes have been added 10, 12 speed gears. Clunkers, you see, are, from what we can tell, the newest California phenomenon. Actually began, it seems, up in Marin County. People who own clunkers take them out into the hills, ride them cross country, and occasionally race them downhill.
Clunkin is taking one of these old junker bikes, putting 10 speeds on it, and going up into the hills and having a ball.
The name of the place is I Like It Like That. Now you say Sally, and I say Sue, and we're gonna rock away all our blues. Come on, come on, let me show you where it's at. Come on.
Clunking is muddy in the winter, and it's dusty in the summer.
It's been estimated that there are probably no more than a couple of hundred clunkers in all of Northern California. And this race today featured about 40 of them. This is the fabled Repack Downhill Race, held for 3 years running now, and organized by a veteran clunker rider named Charlie Kelly.
Charlie Kelly's the organizer of this event. Now, how did the Repack get its name?
Okay, the way it started was we used to ride down on these coaster brakes. I mean, we'd just take an old bicycle and we'd just take it out here and go roaring down the hill. And this hill is so steep and you got to be on the brake so much that when you get to the bottom with just a coaster brake, one brake on your bike, you're on it so much that it's just pouring smoke out of it. I mean, all the grease, and I kid you not, all the grease is just turned into vapor, you know, and it's just pouring out the back. It looks like you're riding a 250 Yamaha with bum rings, you know, and you got smoke pouring out the back. Anyway, all the grease is gone. It's vaporized, and then you got to go home and repack your HUD.
So hence the repack.
Hence the repack, right.
Okay.
Most of the racers ride up to the starting line in the truck, but some of the hardier souls actually walk or ride their bikes up the mountain in order to check out the conditions on the race course. Now, this is the actual starting line, the top of a fire road on top of a mountain here in Marin County. The finish line is 2 miles away and 1,300 feet below where we stand now. They go down 1,300 feet in the course of the race. It's quite a drop. Fisher writes for Bicycle Magazine and works in a bike shop. I hear them calling you the Fish. Why is that?
The Fish? Just a nickname. Maybe it has to do with my riding style. I wiggle in anything's pretty good.
Now, where did this start, Gary?
It started in Larkspur about 12, 15 years ago with some kids. But that's where I saw it start. It's really hard to say where it started because it probably started when men started riding bicycles 100 years ago and they had nothing but dirt roads to ride on.
Mm-hmm. But how about this customizing in a sense where you put on the gears and the big knobby tires?
Well, the big hybrid about 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. And it's come a long way since then and it's going to go a long ways.
The best time ever recorded for a repack race is 4 minutes and 22 seconds, achieved last year by Gary the Fish Fisher. But it's important to note that clunkers are not designed only for downhill races. In fact, some riders say the most enjoyable form of clunking is cross-country riding. They even have a saying that goes, clunking is best away from the cops, the cars, and the concrete. There's more to this, though, than just racing downhill.
Oh, yeah. There's riding around all over all kinds of trails and enjoying nature, enjoying being able to go where you want, using your own power.
Cross-country skiing, almost, as opposed to downhill racing like this seems to be.
Yeah, yeah, and if you fall down, you don't get snow on your boots.
Hang it tight.
We're at one of the switchbacks now along the repack course. This is traditionally one of the spots where riders wipe out. You can see why. Here's what happens on a switchback when a rider loses control of his bike and a camera crew scrambles to save their heads. Everyone emerged unharmed from this, with only the bicycle mangled up a bit. At the end of the race, there's a simple awards ceremony where the winners collect their spoils, new brakes for some, or sometimes just a bottle of wine. Drink later while you try and forget how much your body hurts, and try and remember how much you enjoyed the experience.